Welcome to How to Die in 5 Easy Steps.
Yes, indeed. It is called Lothric, where the transitory lands of the Lords of Cinder converge. In venturing north, the pilgrims discover the truth of the old words. The fire fades, and the lords go without thrones. Nameless, accursed, undead, unfit even to be cinder. And so it is that ash seeketh embers.
And welcome, my vassals, to Let's Play Dark Souls 3. This Let's Play is more of a Let's Die, as Nico B would say. And die we will do. Because I suck at this game. I played Dark Souls 1, I played Dark Souls 2. I've even gotten pretty far in this game. And I was going to start a title screen, but I was going on a rant. So, we're gonna be me, Tyranno, Chaos. Hopefully my dog doesn't walk in here. Not that he really can, but... So we're gonna go with Young. I really like the swords that the mercenary starts off with, but... Did I mention I suck at this game? Because we're starting out with the Pyromancer. And, Let's see. Blessed Holy Water. Crap. Red Eye Orb. Burial item for good fortune after death. Used to upgrade the fire weapon. Oh, here, this is what I was using. The life ring, because the life ring makes the first boss fight pretty easy. So does being a pyromancer. I've played all the way to being a, I've played all the way to the fight with the dog. Anyone who's already played this game knows what I'm talking about. As far as I know, my game is online, but most of you will probably see me play unkindled because I am a coward. That's why I'm a tyrant. Yeah, you see, guys, I became a tyrant not by acquiring power and usurping the throne of whatever kingdom I took over at the time. I did it by cowering in the corner until they gave me the key to the city. And even though the example I gave involved two different settings, it's still valid. Because I say it is. I'm gonna go with that. Let's see. Where is hair? Would be like face? Yeah, here we are. We're gonna get a bit of a beard going on. Yeah, that's the beard that I have. That is actually exactly what my beard looked like. Yeah. Okay, so, gonna get some hair on my head. Not that we'll ever see it, but, it's there. That's kind of what my hair color is. And now I've just got one more thing that I really care about, and we'll be good. We'll just get these right here. And, just bump that up. And there we go. Not gonna bother with the heterochromatics because, I got rid of the angel inside of me a long time ago, so my eyes mostly stick red now. So, here we go. 3, 2, 1. Let's die. Wait, did I get everything right? Did that name right? Funny story, the first time I, before we get into the game, funny story is, I actually made a character, I was gonna make a female character, and then I decided that maybe I should just make myself, because I like to test the game out with me. And, I forgot to change the name, so I had a girl name, which is how I'm going to tell the difference between this file and that file. Also, I have much nicer hair in this game. Also, my hair makes more sense in this version. Okay, let's go. Thank you. I am alive. I have my Omega Shield. I have an axe, which I'm just gonna put away now. I already know what these say, so I'm just gonna skip on by. Gonna do my thing and hurry on along, because I've already done this 4 different times. I know what I'm doing, and I'm gonna get through it really quick so that I don't bore all of you with the details of watching somebody play a Dark Souls game. Though I will take the axe out for now. Don't worry, it will get replaced. There is a weapon I plan to get before I leave. And probably everybody knows what it is. That's what I wanted the axe for. But, you know, I'll keep it on. Because I only have so many uses with the pyromancy. Better to not wait for. I am getting hit by everything. Oh, and you'll notice that I actually have the disappearing HUD. I was amazed that you can actually do this. Ah, headshot. Burning headshot. Now, let's see. Come on, hit me. Target him. Now. Right on the feet. Now, who's ready for Eternal Chaos does something stupid? I know what I'm doing. I told you, this episode is going to be called How to Die in 5 Easy Steps. Actually, no, I didn't tell you that, because I deleted that part of the video. At least I'm supposed to. But, this video's title is How to Die in 5 Easy Steps. First thing is, create a character. You can't die if you don't start. Second, find that thing. Third, run away from this thing. Because you are not powerful enough for it. And I am tense like crazy. I'm just gonna make sure he's following me. I know what I'm doing. Okay, no, he's not. Come here. Alright. Nope, here he comes. Alright. This is how you do this. This is the easiest way to do this, and this is the way I've done it every time so far. Just get this guy to follow you. And then go up this hill. Hello? I feel like they tried to patch this somehow. Okay, this has worked every time since. Did they extend the cliff so that he's not so stupid as to fall off? Yep, they extended the cliff. I know what I'm doing. Well, I guess I... Wait, no, there hasn't been a patch for this game yet. There's no way that they patched that. Also, guys, I'm shattering your eardrum. In true Dark Souls fashion, I am drinking out of the skull. Wait, that's not Dark Souls fashion. Well, whatever. I'm a douchebag. I learned how to be a douchebag from the Xana Uzumaki school of being a douchebag. And also, I've done this part so many times that I am used to it. I'm gonna try this one more time because it's worked every time. Just bear with me. I know it can be done. I've done it 3 different times now. I've just never done it with my pride in. Okay. Oh, nope, he's falling. He is most certainly aggroed onto me. Really, fairly certain he's aggroed onto me. Nope, he's going home. Hey, buddy. Buddy. Always keep an eye on him. Never let him out of your sight until you reach him. And then quickly look back. Always make sure you have a direct line of contact. Eye, line, whatever. That didn't work out like I thought it would. Okay, let's try this again. Oh, I'll take that. And that's what's supposed to happen. I know what I'm doing. That's a non-respawning enemy, so I never have to worry about that again. But now that I think about it, I did miss something while I was over there, so I'll go back and get that. I feel kind of bad, seeing as I did die in the tutorial already. What makes me feel even worse is that there's no achievement in Dark Souls 3 called This Is Dark Souls. For those of you wondering how I got the This Is Dark Souls achievement, I found the giant. The giant just outside the witch's house, which is meant for any exploration type that haven't bothered to get their weapons yet. Yeah, I found him. He sat on me. Because, I hadn't gotten any weapons yet, and, I was not prepared to be sat upon. Also, for those of you wondering, this is not... Who the... Okay. Before I break my general rule, I just want to let everybody know... This is a rated M game. Okay? I'm going to die a lot. For those of you who don't know, I've been to many anger management classes. Yes, I have a problem. I am eventually going to rage. And when I do, the words start flying. Alright. We're gonna ignore those guys for now and see if I can't make this jump. Get that second Titanite shard, that way when I get to my base, I can upgrade. I'm gonna go there just yet. I have what I need to beat, to do what I need to do, but... Alright, what I want to do is... I want to fall on that guy. So I can take this guy out. Reason being, this guy has a shield, that guy didn't. Alright, now I think I have all the items that I wanted to get before I went and fought the boss. Alright. You're no match for tier 1 Dark Souls dungeons. Make sure they don't drop anything. I'm gonna go really quick. It took me forever to learn how to navigate this menu. I'm not even gonna lie about that. That it took me way too long to learn how to navigate this menu. Oh, and that screeching is my PS4. It hates every time I record. It's usually fine when I'm just playing games normally. But it hates it when I try to record. Okay, I think the fire bombs are the only thing I have right now that are really gonna be something I'm gonna need. Alright. Wait. I do have my ashen ones. Yeah, okay. Because I'm gonna need my ashen... Or, what's it called? Yeah, my ashen Estus flask so that I can restore my focus. By the end of this fight. Alright. Only in the first round can you, get the, cheap shots off. And I've heard you can parry this guy, but, I don't think I'm gonna try it, because... anyone wondering, or like anybody who's never played Dark Souls before, Pyromancer, OP, always. I'm gonna light this because there is one thing on the way that actually can kill me. And I want to be ready in case I want to do it first. Let's go. And if you're wondering why I made that look so easy, which I didn't, I actually walked all my Estus in doing so, which doesn't make it look easy at all. But, the reason how I could do it in one shot, I fought that boss like 30 times now. Because when I first fought him, I died like 20 times. And when I did the Pyromancer, I fought him like 5 times. I'm not gonna deal with you. Yep, I'm gonna do it this way. Oh, there's a blood thing. I'm gonna try to remember to be in Kendall for most of the time I'm recording, but that doesn't mean that I necessarily will. That makes two, guys. The video goes until I link the fire, so basically the video's gonna keep going until I get that katana he's got. If none of you know, I love katanas. And it's not just because the Uchi Katana is one of the best weapons in the game. It's because the Uchi Katana is really cool. Did I ever explain that I'm gonna be breaking my rules? Possibly. I think I did, but basically, I have a set of rules that I don't cuss. Yeah, that's gonna be out the window for this game, but I'm still going to try to not if I can, because honestly, I think that just randomly throwing cuss words out isn't entertaining. You guys came here to see something a little bit better than that. Though then again, you guys probably want to see me fight this guy mano a mano. And that's just not gonna happen. There we go. The most well-known way to try and play around on those coffins over there, because that's the most likely way you're gonna get him to throw himself off. But yeah, if you're a pyromancer, you can just use that ash and estus flask you got. Something I saw off of Lubu Fongxian's channel, and if you ever heard me say that name before, it's usually on Dynasty Warriors based content, but he started playing Dark Souls recently on his channel, and he showed me that you can get up there and you can actually snipe them with fireballs, but there's a chance that you'll just completely screw yourself over by getting a bad angle. At least this way you give him a chance. It's slightly more honorable, and by more honorable I mean you still have about as much honor as a rat using poison ability. Did I just make Rattata like a poison type or something? Probably. You talk.
Welcome to the bonfire, unkindled one. I am a firekeeper. I tend to the flame, and tend to thee. The lords have left their thrones, and must be delivered to them. To this end, I am at thy side.
Sorry about that bit of a cut there.
Farewell, Ashen One.
I got thirsty, took a drink. I mentioned I am drinking out of a skull, right? My parents have glasses that look like skulls. Skull would be so jealous that I have these things. Probably not, because he might even have some of his own, but I doubt it. So, wait, do I have a bone? Do I have a bone yet? No, I don't. Oh well, there's plenty of other good stuff up there that I want to go and get anyway. Oops. That didn't take long. Hey, just what I wanted. Alright. I just recently learned that if you go all the way around here, there's actually a really good reward. I'm gonna switch to my shield so I don't accidentally screw this over. And I got it. Okay, well, I don't want to go there just yet, because if I do, then I'm going to have to do the tree thing again. And the tree can be a bit finicky, so... we're going to do one quick thing that I learned from Batividia. And if you've ever played Dark Souls on the internet, you probably, scratch that, you know that name. I'm gonna pass this guy really quick. I don't care. Ooh, sweet. I looked at that piece of landscape out there and I thought it was a specter. Like, why is there a specter staring me down? And no, it's actually just Lothric. Alright, what I need to do is I need to open this, I need to go into the inventory, and I need to leave one homeward bone. And that's what I did it for. The iron bracelets really aren't worth it. They're more defensive than what I've got, but honestly, what I got works for now. So I'm gonna put, I don't know. Let's put it. No, don't. No. We're gonna put that there. There we go. We're gonna grab that. We'll run into that. Is there any way to get down here without taking any damage? I'm actually interested in that. Nope, I don't think there is. Wait, somebody died here? I touched the blood stain. Okay, here we go. Okay, I want to see, like, did he just die from the fact that there was this major jump to get? Alright, and this ring worth putting on, too. That'll help make it so that I get a lot more money. Actually, hold on. I want to try this the way that I made. And that's not gonna work. Oh well. Yep, he actually died by making too many dangerous jumps. Oh, right, I never... Yes, I know I can't use it yet.
Ash produced the Mokton.
Wait, hold on.
Farewell, Ash.
I forgot. What exactly am I short on? Where is the help button again? No. Where's the help? Oh. It says it right there. Explanation. I believe that's dexterity. Yeah. So I need 16 dexterity to wield this.
Ash pretty the mock to love. Very well, then to take no.
So I'm gonna really quick grab the 16. Only 16. Because I might want to use that level up or the soul for later.
Farewell, Ash.
Or I might die before I could use it.
May the flames guide.
There we go. The Uchi Katana. And now that we have it, we're gonna go talk to a good old friend of mine.
Well, a newcomer, I see. I am Andre. I serve at this shrine as a humble smith forging weapons. You're in search of the Lords of Sindhu, I trust. A toilsome journey, I'd wager. You'll require good arms. Let me smith your weapons. I am a smith. Such is my purpose.
I know what I'm doing. So, remember, me and Dark Souls. Dark Souls 1. I never beat the second boss. I beat the first one just fine because I knew exactly what I knew, like, a really good way to cheese it. Well, I guess technically I beat the second boss of Dark Souls 1 because the first one is in the tutorial area, and then you fight the second one, which is the thing on the wall. I can't remember what its name is. But I beat the Asylum Demon, and I beat the first boss outside of the tutorial. But afterwards, I have not beaten the boss that comes after that, because I am scared of it. It is the Gargoyles. And in Dark Souls 1, or Dark Souls 2, I don't think I've actually fought any of the bosses in Dark Souls 2 yet. No, I haven't. So never mind, I haven't even beaten the first boss in Dark Souls 2 yet. And in Bloodborne, I beat the what was it called? The priesthood demon. It's the first thing that most people fight. It's like right outside the shortcut for the first lamp that you run across. And I'm stuck on the Father Gascon fight because I suck. But now that I'm done running my mouth, this has been Terminoi 40, your tyrant of chaos, and, get back to work, because, I know that you've been laughing at me, and for laughing at me, you have to work twice as hard. I should have added that earlier.